Okay, what is going on out there today, people of the internet, people of YouTube? It's a knife unboxing video. You already know what it is. We're going to be using the Spyderco Paramilitary 3. Excuse me, the Para 3 lightweight. It's not a paramilitary. Excuse me. Excuse the hell out of me. You know what? I don't even care. We're just going to run with that. Now, they've taped the living hell out of this box, so I'm just going to make an incision. I gotta watch out for the tripod here. Unbelievable. Live TV now, people. Oh my god. Oh my god. Ooh, that was off screen, wasn't it? Okay, now they've taped the living hell out of this thing. Let's try and get into this, you know, with some civility. Using the Para 3. This is a really nice knife. Trying to get the cut on camera. The only way I can do it is if I cut this one. That's kind of ridiculous. Oh, whatever. Here we go. Oh, geez. Right, I'm gonna put this knife away here. Here we go. Look at that. Okay, now, here we go. Here we go. Look at this, everybody. Look what it says right in there. Quaiken neck knife. Rough finish. Get out of there, you fucking thing. There we go. Here we go. Here we go. Oh, we got a receipt here. Let's get rid of that. Don't need that. There we go. Look at that. I'm kind of liking these new style Emerson boxes. Let's take a look here. Let's see what we've got inside. Okay, here we go. Bubble wrap city. Let's put the box away. Open this up. We got bubble wrap. That probably has, like I said in a previous video, that has coronavirus in it. Baggie containing the knife and looks like some product info and some cautionary words from Emerson. Please use caution when you're pulling this knife out of the sheath. Do not have your offhand near the sheath to avoid cutting your offhand fingers as you draw the knife. Yeah, we're definitely not going to do that. Hopefully not, anyway. Okay, that's all just product info. I don't really care. Ooh, look at this. A sticker. Yeah, I don't know if I have that one yet or not. I think I do. Anyway, here is the knife right here. We have this breakaway chain, which, yeah, I don't know. Take it or leave it. Paracord would have been a little bit nicer. But I get it. Okay, it is loose in the sheath. That's always a good sign. Pull this out here. Oh my goodness, there's not a lot of tension in that sheath at all. Let's try that again. Yeah, it comes out pretty easily. Let me take this chain off of here. Thing's pissing me off. Okay, there we go. Okay, yeah, it's loose in the sheath. Comes out very easily. Let's see here. Well, I can't make it come out of the sheath, and I'm actually really trying to do that. Okay, so, I guess that's good. Whatever, it's a very smooth draw. Well, there it is right there, the Emerson Quaiken neck knife. Pretty cool. That's actually kind of cool, if you ask me. Okay, some quick stats on the blade here. We have a 3¼-inch blade. It is 7¾ inches long overall. 4-inch handle, it's 1/8 thick. Weighs 4 ounces, is made out of 154 cm steel, and for all you nerds out there, this is hardened to a Rockwell hardness of 57 to 59. I don't know why anybody cares about the Rockwell hardness, but some people do, or, you know, at least they claim that they do. Look at that point. I'm pretty sure the camera's picking it up, but there's actually some discoloration at the tip there. They must have got it a little too hot while grinding. I'm pretty sure that'll break, you know, if I actually choose to do anything with this knife. Conventional V-grind with chisel edge, which basically tells me that Emerson was just too lazy to actually grind the edge on the other side of the knife as well. If this was a true chisel edge, it would just be a, you know, it, never mind, whatever. It all comes down to blade geometry. That's what it all comes down to, people. That's what it all comes down to. It's kind of hard to see through the rough finish, but there is the Emerson knife stamp right there, and also 0101 on the blade. I'm guessing this is number 101, and I'm almost positive this is ball shaving sharp. Yeah, oh my goodness, close up of the blade. The rough finish doesn't really give it any texture at all. Do a size comparison next to a Bic lighter. Everyone knows how big a full-size Bic lighter is, at least I hope you do. The two lanyard holes at the back are indeed rounded off, which is something I was not expecting from an Emerson. This central hole here is also rounded off, so if you want to do some kind of, you know, a paracord wrap or some such thing on this knife, you can do so without fear of this knife biting in. Not, you know, just tearing the shit out of your paracord. Because that's a huge problem, apparently. Close up of the edge on this side. This is actually pretty cool. No jimping on the spine at all. Like I said before, it does come with this breakaway chain, which is adequate. I get why they include it, but I would have liked to see some paracord or something a little bit different than this. Whatever. I am actually a little surprised at the play in the sheath. It does draw very smooth. Pshaw! I like the sheath. It's set up for all kinds of cool stuff. Tech locks, all that good stuff. Molly strapping, whatever you want to put on there. I'll probably add some paracord or something like that. I think I have some neon green. That would look pretty cool. Yeah, I like this. It has a highly polished edge. There's a shot of the handle with that, what they call rough finish. It looks kind of rough, but it's not rough at all. It provides absolutely no grippy texture whatsoever. I think that they have very slightly rounded the edges of the knife, and I mean like very slightly. There's a shot of the choil. It also has a sharpening choil as well. Don't ask me why anyone would actually want to wear a neck knife. I really don't know. Some guys do. I actually have a few neck knives. Maybe I will put a video together. You know what the possibilities, they're endless. Let's saddle this bad boy up. Okay, here's the knife in its sheath on the breakaway chain. It hangs really low, but you can adjust that. Finger goes right into the choil and it comes out basically like butter. Be very careful reinserting this. I can't get it to fall out of the sheath. But there is a little bit of play there, but it's super smooth. All right, back inside. Anyway, people, another ridiculous knife to add to my collection. What am I actually going to do with this? Probably absolutely nothing. It's probably just going to sit in my safe until I decide to sell it, I don't know, 10 years from now or something like that. It's just going to sit in my collection and pretty well nobody's going to ever see it, but you know what? I like it, so there's that. The Emerson Quiekin neck knife. I hope I'm pronouncing that properly. I doubt that I am. Check it out, people. I will have an affiliate link in the description. If you want to support the channel, people, under, you know, any way you can, if you want to give me some support, click on that link and shop through the Amazon storefront as well. That's all I'm going to say, people. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Emerson Quiekin neck knife. Go check it out if you're interested. If not, go check out something else. Cut the camera. I'm done.